Oh, goodness.
Okay, how do we feel about losing brain cells? Well, as a white victim of sissification, I will have to cover this on stream tonight. I am so, so sorry, says Riverboat Jack. Apparently, Foreign Man of Foreign Land is still on his bullshit. This was the original title. This is now the title. These fetishes are hate crimes. I'm gonna make one thing straight right now.
I'm gonna drop a hot take that people aren't gonna like.
This person makes no fucking sense. I'm sorry if that seems like, I don't know, problematic or something, because he's black and he's like from somewhere. The Caribbean? I don't even remember. Like, his sense of humor makes no goddamn sense. His metaphors make no goddamn sense. His memes make no goddamn sense. And I feel like we should make fun of him. Check out Riverboat Jack. And apparently, Vosh also reacted to this. We're going to react to this one. White guilt to God pipeline. Oh boy. I bet that this is going to be completely intellectual and not at all anecdotal and opinionated.
White missionary in Haiti taking a selfie with an Ashi Haitian brandishing his ribs. Average Kendrick Lamar found with a block square PFP at a George Floyd rally. Try dealt with BLM in the bio on Tinder. All of the whites, lend me your ears.
All of the whites in there, baby. Extra white, I need you to see.
My big and be them woman them and man them.
What is happening? What has happened? We just started. You know what the, I swear to God, you know what this, what is even going on? This is a true statement and way too relatable of a question. You know what this reminds me of? That's me! That's me! Yo, we got four men of foreign land back here and this is me. Yo, literally.
You're on camera. Look at him. He's got so spooked.
Gotcha.
Spooked. Spooked.
This is not scary. It's just abnormal.
Extra white, I need you to see.
My big and be the woman and man them. Green textile. Big body foreign. Yes, they call me that. Yes, the whole thing.
No, they don't. They don't call you that. That's not a nickname you have. Who's this?
Big body foreign. Yes, they call me that. Yes, the whole thing. A political scientist watching Oppenheimer, expecting a historical espionage movie about a.
Why is this a 4chan post? I don't get it. Why? What's the metaphoric significance that you're trying to put forward with this subliminal messaging that you got going on here? What I don't understand.
About a period that's indelible and intimacy and tragedies established the new world order. This is no hyperbole. From the what? Way that nations negotiate with one another, the apartheid.
Wait, I'm sorry. Hang on. Wait. Did he just? Hold on. Did he just say hyperbole?
This is no hyperbole. From the way that
hyperbola? Hyper what?
This is no hyperbole. From the way that nations negotiate with one another, the apocryphal dogmas that we cling to every unit of analysis.
Is this turning into a conspiracy theory? What is happening?
As big as systems or as infinitesimal as individuals. This period, and arguably the ape itself, has altered the world on a metaphysical level. So given these grandiose expectations and the fact that it's from...
Why did you blur out Hitler's face? I don't under... Is that against YouTube TOS? Does that like fuck up your monetization? I don't... Okay.
One of my favorite auteurs. I had high expectations auteurs? For Oppenheimer. But I left the movie with a massive headache due to the shots of sub-bass that would rival any Gucci Mane song during his lean gut era. Which is undoubtedly my favorite Gucci and just the superior Gucci in general.
Okay, objectively, okay, listen,
I'm gonna drop a hot take that people aren't gonna like.
That was the best Gucci era, yeah.
But I dragged
that was actually my first introduction to Gucci in high school, was that song, actually. Fuck, I totally forget. What was it, Kitchen? In the Kitchen? I don't remember. But it went hard, and I was like, yo, this is actually a bop. Okay, all right, maybe I do like hip-hop. Maybe I do like rap. It's, okay. Well, this is called trap? Oh, word. Why is it called trap? And then I learned about crack.
Now, I must be a glutton for pain. To make anything but a Nolan Gok 3000 review on what was obvious Oscar bait.
What?
But I regret to inform you that while I had mixed feelings on...
Okay, I need closed captioning.
I am as certain as the indictment of a black man accused of any crime in Montana about one thing.
I mean, I haven't even watched it because I have a century.
Oh, here we go. The token white person to make, to validate your, okay.
What's that?
I mean, just like, it's like, you know, aggrandizing a dude who made a side machine.
Yes!
Yeah, and it's like, oh, but he was sad. And I'm like, the land they experimented on did belong to indigenous folk. And I guess they were like let back on the land after it had been basically irradiated. So a bunch of indigenous folk, after they were like allowed back onto the land.
But first, some disclaimers. Now, I give y'all cretins enough time to watch this movie, so this video gonna be more spoiled than Miss Johnson egg salad sandwich left out in the sun for 40 days and 40 nights. And all-
What is up with your analogies? I'm going to lose my fucking mind. What? Who?
Miss Johnson egg salad son.
Who's Miss Johnson? I don't know. Who's this Miss Johnson? Is this a reference I'm just missing out on? Is my Caucasity showing? I don't get it. I don't understand.
Which left out in the sun for 40 days and 40 nights. And also, it is literal history. If you don't know the story about the Manhattan Project and World War II in general and international relations, then take it up with the American scholastic system or the Canadian one, wherever it is. Not with Big Body Foreign and in Big Body Foreign's comment section.
Nobody calls you Big Body Foreign, I'm sorry. I don't believe this. This is not a factual statement. Also, I don't really care to watch Oppenheimer. It's just, whatever. I'll watch it when it comes out on Netflix. I don't care.
Oh! Now, without further ado, I about to cook Oppie like the rent do, because the rent is in fact due, yes Lord. With the release of Oppenheimer and the impending iteration of
I mean
Napoleon, that wasn't a gaffe, but you knew that already, as well
what?
As the many historic biopic Netflixified dramas that yassify folks who took oaths to never be pretty and to always be cruel, we have bore witness to a phenomena that refuses to be ignored.
So I watched Schindler's List. I don't know if you've ever watched it. Put yourself through the emotional labor of watching.
Oh God, I am very scared about what's about to be said. Oh boy. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, so you watched Schindler.
I watched Schindler's List. I don't know if you've ever watched it. Put yourself through the emotional labor of watching that. I knew it was this canonical film to understanding and appreciating the Holocaust, but I never watched it because it was before my time. The part that really f***ed me up, I don't know if you recall this part, but it's when...
Is it the ring bit? He's crying over the rings? Honestly, the most stuff is when they melted down all the gold fillings from Jewish people and they made gold ingots.
They made it into a ring for... What's his name in Schindler's List?
Oh, I forgot about that bit.
I'm sorry. Like white saviorship in the worst way.
This is gold. To more people. I could have got one more person. And I didn't.
Bro! why can't you? Okay. Oh my god. I'm okay. Oh my god. Why can't a movie just be a movie, bro? Yo, if you can't just let a movie be a fucking movie with a good message and a good story, then you're the fucking problem. I mean, it's different if you're like a film critic, you know, and like that's your thing, you know, and you're into like watching cinematic pieces and being like, okay, I'm gonna break this down, or I'm gonna explain the ending, or I kind of had a problem with the way the director did this. They changed the script up from this to that, and I like the original script. But like, that's different. That's different. He said something about white savior shit, and then like a very touching scene came up from Schindler's List. What are you trying to? What are you criticizing? What, it's white savior shit to like have to like go through a situation like that in World War II when you're trying to protect Jews from the Holocaust? Like, I don't get it. What is happening?
I think Steven Spielberg made the movie to upset Gentiles. I think he was like, you need to understand, because Jewish people, I don't think, need to be traumatized in this way. I think he specifically made this movie to make Gentiles feel bad and understand, and that's why he made it
No! What? Okay, hold on. Wait, I've only seen Schindler's List once, so I could be way off the mark here. Okay? It's been a while since I watched Schindler's List, okay? But, like, first of all, this is why I don't trust content creators who tokenize anyone to, like, further validate their shitty points, which is objectively what he's doing here. Oh, look, there's a white lady right here who's agreeing with me. So, you know what? I'm correct. No, that doesn't... What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? And she just has... What is this shitty take? What are you talking... So, okay. Steven Spielberg... Okay, you're alleging that Steven Spielberg made this movie to make Gentiles feel bad. Or maybe... Maybe it was a piece of media amongst a whole plethora of other pieces of media that are taking a very, very heavy, touchy, just dark subject such as the Holocaust and World War II, and like through artistry and correctly and beautifully appealing to emotion, trying to get the point across that Holocausts are cringe. Like, maybe that's it. Maybe, like, does it have to be like I feel like that there's a huge red flag here of like, let me just insert my bias here, and people who already have that bias and who would agree with me will validate that bias for me.
Schindler in real life was a piece of up until he wasn't. There's at least some better stuff going on in this.
I mean, I don't, maybe that's true. I don't know. I haven't looked into it that much. She could be right there. Maybe the real Schindler was actually a piece of shit. But if you think about it, like, so was Gandhi. Like, didn't Gandhi like have some weird fucked up shit with like someone who was underage, like an underage girl or some shit? And Martin Luther King cheated on his wife, and it's just like, dude, like, people who do great deeds are probably guilty of some shitty shit, because wow, they're people. Wow, imagine that. No, there's no such thing as a flawless human. That's crazy, bro.
Film than there is in other righteous Gentile movies. Like, there is a Jewish character. We know his name. He has scenes. We know how he feels about stuff. And that's better than, like, the zookeeper's wife.
Schindler's List, which is ostensibly about Oskar Schindler, a literal card-holding member of the Nazi party. But we sort of like him, right? Since he saved the lives of...
Why do you, oh my god, why? Just say it, just say, what? Oh my god, okay, follow me on this real quick.
Member of the Nazi party. But we sort of like him, right? Since he saved the lives of...
Saved the lives of, like... You could have just said amount, number of Jews. You could have just said that. What is up with this, like, oh, look at me, I'm so, like, relatable with, like, my fucking camera angles and my... I'm fumbling the camera a little bit to, like, make some, like, insanely extra and unnecessary and needless transition to something else. I hate this shit so much. I really do.
Future foreign here and I... But I'm gonna leave my errand here for transparency. I said this throughout this section rather than Jewish folk then. And while my friend Lady Knight the Brave doesn't have an issue with it, she did note that some Jewish folk them may actually have some. So I just want to clarify, please don't mix me up with the anti-Judaism and the anti-Semite folk them. Please don't. All right, thanks, bye.
Could we, like, maybe clarify a little bit? I don't know. I honestly have no idea what he's talking about.
Since he saved the lives of 1,200 Jews in an immaculate transformation from capitalist opportunists to, and I say this with the utmost cheek,
the Jefferson. The Thomas Jefferson.
Of Jews. And to be fair, during this period...
Huh? What? Okay, hold on. Wait. What? Oh, I get it. Okay. So, Jefferson advocated for... He was an abolitionist. Okay. And he was an... and he was a slavery accelerationist. Okay, interesting. So, I mean, to be expected, he was a founding father, so he was definitely going to be a dumb fuck. You know, that makes sense. But I don't think they're the same thing. Wow, it's almost like this person has, like, a proclivity to, like, make white people into, like, a monolith.
And to be fair, during this period, he was the catch-22. But the treatment that figures like Schindler gets is, well... Anyway, Spielberg himself made this.
You could just explain it in words. Use your words. Instead of these weird fucking transitions, you got. I don't.
But the treatment that
the treatment
like
that
Schindler
figures like Schindler
is,
gets is.
Well,
no words. He just. But I guess what he's trying to imply here is like. You're supposed to feel sorry for Schindler, you know? But it's like, dude, he literally saved 1,200 Jews. He had that privilege with the Nazi party and was just like, I can use this to avoid suspicion while I literally save all these Jews.
Spielberg himself made this movie. Yes, that's Spielberg. The Berg is Jewish himself. And as soon as he got a chance to tell the unfortunate story of many Jews, this is his vantage point. And it ended up essentially cementing Liam Neeson on the silver screen for years to come. This movie would go on to be regarded as the quintessential film for understanding the repugnance of a word that ironically cannot be said on this platform, otherwise YouTube ad revenue go bye-bye. Which, in a way, kind of illustrates my point. The laundering of one's image via letterbox ratio and string swells. At the risk of being reductive, Schindler is being swallowed in a sea of Jews and snot-nosed, ugly crying over how he could have saved but one more had he been more altruistic with his grotesque, profligate amount of wealth, rather than spending it on a montage of misogyny and opulence. But let's blacken this up.
Maybe there's some things I'm just not remembering from when I watched Schindler's List. But what the fuck what are you talking about? Does anyone have any idea? I still don't know what this guy is talking. I don't know what is happening.
Humor me. Say this one.
Jefferson.
And all of his ex-slaves clamored around him as he bellowed. Had I saved one more Ashi Negro, I could have saved more had I not been so busy them.
Now I am.
Okay, that's kind of funny. That's kind of funny. I'll give him that. Credit where credit's due. That's kind of funny.
I must find that funny though, because I'm white and that means I'm racist.
I feel like this dude just goes with the same formula for the same point, but like just uses different like metaphors and forms of media and transitions and stuff. You know, like Jesus Christ.
I ain't calling Thomas Jefferson a villain.
But I also ain't gonna call him no hero. That's
literally what's up? What is up with the volume changes? Oh my God, dude.
Now I ain't calling Thomas Jefferson a villain.
But I also ain't gonna call him no hero. That's literally
Jefferson.
Far different from a party member of arguably the most heinous party next to Mussolini's himself.
He's my favorite dictator of all time. Joey, you really gonna make me do this? You're really gonna make me do this? What, you know the answer? This is gonna get people upset, probably. 3, 2, 1. Mussolini. I put none, how dare you?
Oh, shit.
What I will say is that it's one thing to make a villain sympathetic in completely fictional works, like one of my favorites, Thanos, or every incel's favorite, Joker.
Can we get one thing straight real quick, okay? Like, I really hate the incels have taken the Joker. I really hate it. I really do. Because honestly, like, if you just use your fucking brain cells for 5 more seconds, you would realize that the Joker is, at least what, like, with Joaquin Phoenix, is the direct byproduct of capitalism not serving the interests of the common man, okay? I'm not gonna go on a tangent.
It takes a talent to humanize malefactors, render their ominous objectives relatable or warranted, like in Killmonger. Not only does it make for a film that allows the viewer to feel conflicted in who to root for, ergo edging the tension, like insert salacious horny meme here. I can't think of any, but it humanizes humans. This communicates to us that these villains aren't some mythical creature, but your neighbor next door, your Uncle Bernie from Harbor Island, or the white kid at your school that ended up being the head of a neo group that tried to overwhelm the power grid, leaving majorly black Americans in the Elsa frozen weather of winter. Anyway, humanizing villains demonstrate that humans are capable of incredible feats that
I mean, yeah, that's bad. What point were you trying to get across by bringing that up?
Push humanity forward as much as we are capable of the most depraved acts that bugle to an absent god, to send a flood. I'm not kidding. The world is an awful place. I am no longer afraid to die. This is a fine exercise of cinema.
I'm now nervous laughing. What was that?
I'm not kidding. The world is an awful place. I am no longer afraid to die.
This guy's crazy.
This is a fine exercise of cinematic creation.
Listen, like, okay, so here's the thing. Like, I get that sentiment. I get that sentiment, but like, that's not okay.
I'm gonna drop a hot take that people aren't gonna like.
I get that sentiment, but that's not something you say out loud. Does that make sense? Like, that's just kind of something that you just kind of like, we all know, we all nod at each other, but we don't say it, because if we said it, we would rightfully think that person's gonna shoot up a school or something. Like, I don't know. It's just, that's a little weird.
This is a fine exercise of cinematic creativity when done with comic book characters and IPs, because you can't make something new for some damn reason, so you have to ruin people's childhood to the point where David Diggs, frontman of one of my favorite industrial hip-hop groups, Clipping, but also an actor on Blackish and our future in a play about rapping slaves.
Okay, so basically they copyright struck me for this. I'm just going to do my best rendition of this.
Na 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 na.
Raise a glass
to freedom. Something they can never take away. No matter what they tell you.
Ain't this about a bitch?
To the point where...
True. Hot take, Hamilton is so fucking underrated. Oh my god. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad I'm not the only one who kind of thinks this. I'm not going to say it's bad, but it's kind of like, you know what Hamilton is? Hamilton is like a pretty good hot dog. Hot dogs are good. Hot dogs are good. They're delicious. But I don't like hot dogs so much that I need one all the fucking time. Nor do they make me cum in my pants. Well, there's few wieners that make me cum. Hot dogs, they're great, but they're not amazing. Hamilton's good. It's just not that good. It's far from bad. It's just liberals fucking nut in their pants as soon as they see it. Yeah, literally. You know, because founding fathers something something or other.
Diggs will forever be brought up in my comment section because people think that the abomination of an accent that he did for Sebastian is somehow redolent of mine, a Bahamian. I mean, this man didn't even try to center a specific Caribbean country. He literally tried to do a Caribbean regional accent. My high blood pressure. It's moments like these.
Dude, if you're getting high blood pressure off of that, then like maybe... oh my god.
I'm gonna drop a hot take that people aren't gonna like.
I gotta be honest with you, brother. If that raises your blood pressure like that, there's lots of people that would wish to have your problems.
I wish we took ADHD more seriously in the Bahamas, because what was I saying?
Right. What have you been saying? No, this is true. What have you been saying? What are you saying? We are 11 minutes into this fucking video. What are you saying? What are you saying? What are you saying? I'll tell you what I'm saying. Half of a sentence, transition, fumble a camera, seem very relatable and quirky. I gotta clarify something that like is perfectly fine to say. I don't think it's TOS or anything. By the way, something something Steven Spielberg, white savior, Schindler's List. Whites. What are you saying? What is the point of this? I swear to God, dude, foreign man in a foreign land, dude. He's just one of those black creators that like will just is just begging for any. You know what? Yo.
I'm gonna drop a hot take that people aren't gonna like.
Foreign man in a foreign land and other black creators like him are to talking about white people what conservatives are when talking about the Second Amendment. Give me a reason. Just give me a reason to. Please, just give me a reason to. Please. Oh my. Give me a fucking reason to. I'm so fucking close to coming. For real though. Like, these motherfuckers are just begging. They're aching to talk about white people in some negative, derogatory way. The same way that fucking gun nuts in this country are like, my guns! Don't take away my guns! I'd like to see you try to take them. Jesus Christ, dude. Calm the fuck down, dude. Like, I swear to God, what are you saying? What are you saying? I don't know.
What was I saying? Right. Fictional characters, fine. Historical villains that have had indelible effects on this Dantinian inferno that we call Earth. No, baby boy. What is you doing? These narratives, though critical of the ultimate actions of these characters of history, still take the time to paint a portrayal of their lives and leave layers of sympathetic portrayal. Films teach us how to watch them. And they also, in lieu of a robust educational system, teach you history by showing the villains' upbringings, their struggles, their pains, and their regrets. They're teaching you that this could be you, young Manila wafer colored boy that listens to too much Taking Back Sunday and only says the N-word when you play COD. That one time, seriously, bro, GG. And if you...
Dude, I... Listen. That's funny on one level because it's true. It's not funny on another level because, like, literally, you're making white people do a monolith. You're doing the thing that white people are constantly accused of. Constantly. Especially by the right wing.
But now you're doing it. You're doing the thing. What are you doing? There's so many extremely valid reasons to critique whiteness, and I love to do it personally, but this is so incomprehensible. There's nothing wrong with critiquing whiteness. But like, okay, so here's the, oh God. And there's not even really anything wrong with like, having a resentment against white people. Like, I get it, all right? But like, say it. Like, just say it. Just be honest about, I resent white people. And these are the reasons why. Like, just, why the fucking veneer? Why veil it, you know? And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get some motherfucker like, you know, being like, well, we can't be honest about it because we always get criticized about it. You know, it's kind of like the whole, like, you know, oh, why can't you just protest peacefully? Why does it have to be rioting and looting for Black Lives Matter? Why can't you peacefully protest? But we've been kneeling, we've been holding signs. That's not what I'm saying. If you're going to critique white people and whiteness, and if you're going to critique depictions of historical figures who were white, you know, could you maybe not do it in a way that, like,
I'm gonna drop a hot take that people aren't gonna like?
Is insulting? Does it have to be in a way to where it's like, ha ha ha, 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 whitey, white, white, he has white skin, so I can say something like, kind of like degrading and demeaning and mean about them. Melanin deficient. Mayo demon. Like, it's just like, it's like, and it's so low effort. And it's so just like, it's not clever. And it's like, it's not mentally stimulating. It doesn't challenge ideas or anything. It doesn't do anything other than make you look like a fucking asshole. Like, that's all it does. That's the only thing you're successful at, bro. It's just looking like a dick. That's it. You know? And here's the thing. I bet you there's a motherfucker who's gonna respond to me saying that just now and be like, oh man, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to trigger your precious little fee-fees, YT. And it's like, dude, it's not even like that. It's just, I don't know, if you're gonna make content to put on the internet criticizing whiteness and the unjust social hierarchy here in the United States and really the Western world as a whole, make it smart and actually make sense. I still don't know what he's talking about. We are 12 minutes into this bitch. I have no idea what's going on. I'm fine with white people including myself to be made into a monolith. It isn't true, but it doesn't translate to real harm, so like, eh, whatever. I'm not saying it translates to real harm, but like, it's just annoying. And personally, I do have a problem with being made into a monolith. Because, like, not because of being made into a monolith in and of itself, but it's like, if you're going to do that with people who look like me, do not say that I do that with people who look like you. You have lost that argument from your arsenal. You have taken that and you have thrown it into a vat of acid. You can't say that anymore. You can't say that because now you're doing the thing. You're now doing the thing. And like, shut the fuck up, you know? This video is 54 minutes long and there's two separate parts for something called the anti-hero problem. I don't know. I have no clue. Fictional characters, right? Okay, that's apparently what he's talking about. What?
If you know Foucault, then you know how this goes. And so it goes. The postmodernism will retell the story. And with each new portrayal, the image gets softer, more palatable. You know who we don't see this happen to, however? We people who are darker than blue. We're not afforded that level of dimensionality or revisionist history, or when we do get it, it's normally to our detriment. Like the co-opting of MLK's legacy, Malcolm X's, Marcus G- Actually, I can't even lie. Mine was on some other shit, but you know, you get what I'm saying.
Did you know this black man was able to pack out Madison Square Garden with 30,000 people for a black revolution? Yeah, I ain't never learned about him in school. Born 1887 in Jamaica, Marcus Garvey showed how powerful we could be if we come together as a nation. He pushed stopping the division between black people to diminish their separate labels for each other and realize the oneness of Africa where we come from, impacting the black community drastically. First person to tell his people that their roots come from so much than what was shown. His people would even call him Moses for his dedication for an independent black nation. He was the first person to try to create a separate economy of black-owned businesses, giving thousands of black people in the community jobs, showing that we need to have our best interest for us. We need to remove division and form organizations so we can build a nation, not support a nation that was built off our demise, emphasizing that the black skin is not a badge a shame, but rather a glorious symbol of greatness. No matter what you want to call yourself, this brings us together.
You ain't gonna see a biopic.
Okay, so real quick, based. Yeah, pretty cool motherfucker. And there was nothing about what that dude was saying that was like at all disagree. Honestly, like, I feel like I got more out of that, 60-70 second TikTok than I have the past 13 fucking minutes of this guy's video. Like, that was I got so much more out of that. Hold up, what was even the point of bringing that up? Hang on.
Or revisionist history, or when we do get it, it's normally to our detriment.
Are there... I mean, I get what he's saying, but at the same time, this is such a blanket statement that I don't know if it's true. All I'm gonna say is that, you know, you have to be big brain enough to get, you know, to understand metaphors, you know. But to be quite frank, they cloned Tyrone a bit on the nose, you know. Like I'm just saying, like, I don't know, man. I just don't buy that there's never been a film or two or three or five or 15 that, like, didn't humanize black people a little bit more from a historical standpoint. I just don't buy that. I'm not gonna say that there aren't media pieces that seem to go down that route, but actually are, you know, like, basically a modern minstrel show, you know. Even nowadays, like, it just sounds hyperbolic as fuck.
You ain't gonna see a biopic on Idi Amin that humanizes him, but you will see one on a particular failed Austrian artist that rhymes with Stifler. You'll be sitting in international relations 420 blazed and listen to a frothy mouth lecturer tell you about the Treaty of Versailles and how it unfairly admonished Germany, thus leading to the material conditions that allow for fascism to thrive. But you won't hear that for Haiti, will you? Despite it actually being the truth, unlike the former. You'll hear that Germany had to...
I'm gonna drop a hot take that people aren't gonna like.
Whenever I hear shit like this, where it's like, you'll hear this, that, and the other thing, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, all the way down to Z, right? You'll hear all these things for this thing. When it comes down to something that's historically black, you know, you won't hear it. I gotta be honest, man. I feel like a part of that problem is the fact that, like, a majority of Americans are white. I know, it's unfortunate. And maybe our education system is very skewed from telling the truth about black history. More unfortunate. And because of these things mixed together, on top of the fact that because of this and the conditions that were bred from these other two things as aforementioned, you might be impatient with the average white American, you know, and be like, maybe I don't have an obligation to educate you, and now there's no conversation happening. And then you come back and you're like, wait, why aren't we talking about Haiti? Maybe motherfuckers just don't know about Haiti. I don't know. Like, why is it, like, I feel like it's always coming from a place of, like, malevolence, when maybe it should be ignorance. Maybe. Because I know that there are definitely, let me put it to you this way, okay? I was one of five white kids in an all-black high school, okay? You know what we didn't learn about? Black Wall Street. You know what we didn't learn about? The fucking Tulsa Race Massacre. You know what we didn't learn about? The fact that police, American law enforcement, American policing, started out as fucking slave patrols. We didn't learn none of that shit, but it was an all-black high school. I was one of five white kids at an all-black high school. We didn't learn none of this shit. We didn't learn none of this shit. You know who else? Yo, we learned about Malcolm X. Very watered down. We learned about MLK. Didn't mention economic democracy or socialism. But you know what else we did not learn about? Oh my God, I'm blanking. I'm blanking right now. I am blanking. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, I am blanking like a motherfucker. You see, I'm sorry, my whiteness is, it's the backup whiteness generators kicked in, and now I'm blanking on his name. First of all, the first name that comes to mind is Angela Davis. We also didn't learn about her. All right, there he is. Hang on. Fred Hampton. Jesus fucking Christ. Fred Hampton, that's what I was thinking of. Jesus fucking Christ. I just put me in the fields now. Just reverse racism now. Reverse slavery now. Just put me in the fucking cotton fields, okay? I deserve it at this point. I'm sorry. My white guilt is really shit. Listen, it sometimes happens that motherfuckers forget a name, just like how a lot of us don't even know the history to fucking begin with. See, like an actual authentic, I forgot, what the fuck, like who I was thinking of, still serves my point even further. So I'm just saying, like, I don't know, like, maybe, like, don't presume evil where there should be, like, ignorance or stupidity. Maybe.
If you slide for your brethren Archduke Ferdinand and start a multinational internecine war, then I don't know, maybe you might get slayed for that. And not in a good way.
Your whole world gets slayed.
You'll hear that was unfair. But you won't hear that Haiti had to pay back France amidst a litany of other injustices for France getting slaughtered by slaves. I hope that Napoleon documentary got that. I'm sorry. This could be a little ADHD rant. But the French, y'all can never run on with big body foreign. Because you all get bodied by a bunch of toiled and soiled slaves, as well as get mowed over by Germany in like a month. If it weren't for your African colonies, you would be like me with no... You wouldn't have... Anyway, where was I?
I'm going to give this 5 more minutes. We're going to go to the 20-minute mark. And if I don't hear one salient, sensical fucking point, we're done.
It's the mayonnaised malefactors that get the anti-hero treatment. They also get folding chairs to the face, but I digress. White folks are treated with a level of levity.
Hang on. No. Wait. Hold on. Wait. Hang on. Wait. No. Hang on. Wait.
It's the mayonnaised malefactors that get the anti-hero treatment. They all...
Listen, even more so than Martin Luther King, I think Malcolm X was like one of the most hated and unpopular figures during the civil rights movement. Malcolm X was objectively a good fucking movie.
White folks are treated with a level of levity when it comes to their sentencing by the judge in the court of life. Time. Aided by the systemic advantages, benefits of every doubt, and historical head start in getting ahead of the narrative.
Right.
White folks write their stories, and they write them well. They revisit where they look bad and made themselves look misunderstood, impossible.
This is true.
Or in the case of Orpi, conflicted. You see, I get back to Orpi. There's a scene, I mean...
Here's the thing, like, it might be less than 5 minutes, I'm not gonna lie. So maybe those particular figures, you know,
they were misunderstood or conflicted? Have you ever thought that maybe they just were? Okay. All right.
I'm not going to spoil too much, but I mean, it's Oppenheimer, so who the fuck cares?
You can spoil it all. My sister told me there's a line about give it back to the
enemy. Yes! Yes! Man is talking to Truman. And Truman. He's talking to Truman and one of his toadies, his sycophants. Truman asks him and say, okay, this was a great success. We bombed the fuck out of a whole country. So what are we going to do with Los Alamos? And Oppenheimer totally said, give it back to the Indians.
There's this one line in the movie that sounds pretty ahistorical, where they're saying we're doing this because we want to stop what the Nazis are doing to the Jews. It's hard to know exactly because so much of it was rumor and stuff at the time, but basically people didn't know what they were doing.
Yeah, exactly.
Most people didn't know what they were doing until the camps. Even Oppenheimer with his government connections probably didn't know because nobody knew.
And the conflict comes in the form of guilt, specifically white guilt, which is different from other forms of guilt. When I did an anti-fatness, when I did homophobia, I made an apology. And I try every day to better myself when it comes to that. When particular white folks experience guilt, it turns them into gods. It deifies an inner demon. It's no longer about expiating for an error. But it mutates into something else.
It's always white people because there's so much guilt, especially white women, there's so much guilt where the people who are being affected usually just figure out a way how to overcome.
Well, they appropriate everything, including rage. They borrow problems that aren't theirs.
Of course.
And they take them and say, I'm going to solve this for you.
Yeah.
Because you're too weak to solve it yourself. And then they say, I'm using my privilege. No, you're not. You're on Facebook making everyone feel bad for being human.
Okay, so quick addendum. This man is obviously a conservative grifter, a man with a mic, if you will. And I would rather blush and die than to be caught agreeing publicly in video format, in a letterbox, big body forum personally. I would rather blush and die than be caught agreeing with this man. This man honestly looks like a bald vagina, literally a Brazilian waxed vagina with eyebrows. This man is so right, the man blows in the dark. However, man is right about some things and wrong about the next. So first off, right off the bat, my mom goes right to the misogyny. Man went straight for the white women there. I mean, ain't nobody hate white women more than white men, my lord. Secondly, man says that we people will overcome.
Nobody hates women, period, more than white men, let's be honest.
We people, of course, know who he's referring to. And naturally that negates the centuries of privilege that has been aggregating, if there was a credit, a privilege credit score, that just been accruing interest nonstop.
Right.
Negate the fact that in your bank account you got all this privilege, and where did you have to get it from? Because someone had to be exploited in order to gain that privilege. Man is saying that, okay, well, since he personally did not do anything, then he is not responsible for it. He will just benefit from all the privilege inside his bank account and not try to find any way to not directly give anyone that privilege, because you can't directly give anyone privilege. However, you can use your proximity and your beneficiary status of the systems in place to maybe help lessen the, equal the playing fields a little bit,
I'm going to drop a hot take that people aren't going to like.
How? How?
Do you have a proposition? I'm gonna think legislation, unless you mean violence, which will make the movement look bad anyways. But then if we join a movement for violence in order to help, in order to reallocate our privilege, then we're called white saviors anyways for doing that. If we would be called that for doing legislation to reallocate privilege to black people and other non-white people, but at the same time he wants to use our proximity and our beneficiary status to— what do you want? 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 What the fuck do you want? What 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 do you want? I'm gonna give you one more minute. I'm gonna give you one more minute to make an actual point that makes fucking sense. We have been doing this for 20 minutes into your video, let alone my reactions to all the dumb shit and all of the dumb editing. Say something that makes a modicum of fucking sense, please.
They ain't gonna stop me from getting gunned down by police like an NPC in GTA 5. However,
so then what the so okay. Oh my god. So if it's not gonna do anything, oh my god. Oh my god. Okay. So if it's not gonna do anything about you getting quote unquote gunned down by police like an NPC in GTA 5, okay? If it's not gonna do that anyways, then what the why are you even talking about fucking white privilege in a way, like as if like, well, it's up to white people to transfer the fucking privilege, you know, or to reallocate it to where like it empowers non-white people, right? Which I totally agree. But then if it's not gonna do anything anyways, then why the fuck are you gonna try to fucking guilt us into fucking trying to do that, and then you call that white guilt or white savior shit? So it's like, well then why fucking do it in the first place? Because then we're not gonna be the fucking villains if we do it or if we don't do it. What the fuck do you fucking want? This is what the fuck I'm talking about. This is what the fuck I am talking about. This is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. When you have someone whose basic politics is bad no matter what, don't take them seriously. Holy fuck, dude. I can't. I'm glad I'm not online enough to be familiar with this stuff, because IRL people just see you doing good things and go, hey, that's pretty cool, dude. Thank you. Oh my god. Like, why can't good people... Oh my god. Why can't good deeds just be good deeds? Or good films just be good films? Good stories just be good stories? Like... It has to, like, there always has to be some fucked up ulterior motive behind it and shit. And it's just like, dude, no, it's just Oppenheimer, Schindler was just like trying to fucking hide some Jews. Like, that's all he was doing. Why does it have to be white savior shit? Why can't it just be a fucking dude who was like, hey, I'm part of the Nazi party. Guess what? Oppenheimer's this. I'm part of the Nazi party. Don't clip that. I'm gonna use my privilege as being a beneficiary and highly proximate to this dominating force that is trying to kill all of you by hiding you in here, because that would be the last place that they would expect to look. Would be under the floorboards of a business that is owned by a member of the Nazi party. They would never expect that. So I'm gonna try to do that. I'm gonna try to use my privilege to help out those who are being fucking oppressed. If they weren't Jews and they were black people, you would call that shit, you already did call that shit white savior shit. Jesus fucking Christ. I can't do this.
It ain't gonna stop me from getting gunned down by police like an NPC in GTA 5. However, it may help when people will only listen to you about particular things that I've been saying. And lastly, man said that y'all are not advocates. Y'all are not-
I... Alright, well, first of all, I looked this up. Favorability for AOC. Very favorable, somewhat favorable. You can combine those and get you, what, 37%, 43%, don't know. You could probably split that. Okay, so it's like, it's close to like, you know, maybe a little bit more, a little bit less favorable to unfavorable. But like, originally what I was going for was like, the squad in general. Like, I gotta be honest, man. A lot of fucking people, especially a lot of liberals, even a lot of white liberals, really like the squad. So...
It may help when people will only listen to you about particular things.
I, as far as all the Progressive Caucus is concerned, the only whiteoid that I can think of is Bernie Sanders. That's pretty much it. A lot of people listen to them about a myriad of particular subjects. So, the fuck are you talking about? It's incredible to me that her and Bernie share quite a lot of stances on things. And a lot of people hate AOC but love Bernie. Yeah, well, you know why that is. It's because she's a woman. Who won't fuck them, you know? Because conservatives are fucking freaks.
Y'all are not advocates. Y'all are not activists. But y'all are just people on Facebook going around making...
What the fuck are you doing, then? What are you doing? 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 You are making videos on fucking YouTube and not making a single cohesive fucking point in 19 minutes and 26 seconds. Holy shit. We are more than a third into this video and I still don't know what exactly the core subject of the quote-unquote white guilt to God pipeline is. What is it? Is it like, okay, so is it the Bo Burnham thing? Okay, you know what?
12 seconds later.
The simple narrative taught in every history class is demonstrably false and pedagogically classist. Don't you know the world is built with blood and genocide and exploitation? The global network of capital essentially functions to separate the worker from the means of production. And the FBI killed Martin Luther King. Private property is inherently theft. And neoliberal fascists are destroying the left. And every politician, every cop on the street protects the interests of the pedophilic corporate elite. That is how the world works.
Really?
That is how the world works. Genocide the natives, say you got to it first. That's how it works.
That's pretty intense.
Pretty intense.
No shit.
What can I do to help?
Read a book or something, I don't know. Just don't burden me with the responsibility of educating you. It's incredibly exhausting.
I'm sorry, Sokka. That's
Twitter.
I was just trying to become a better person.
Why do you rich fucking white people insist on seeing every socio-political conflict through the myopic lens of your own self-actualization? This isn't about you. So either get with it or get out of the fucking way.
Watch your mouth, buddy. Remember who's on whose hand here.
But that's what I'm... Have you not been fucking listening? We are entrenched
all
in a...
Right,
wait, no, please, I don't want to go back. I can't go back. Please. Please.
Okay, so I just took a 54 minute and 35 second video that we were almost 20 minutes into, and I guess basically made his point for him using Bo Burnham, which isn't even my content, to prove his fucking point for him. Without all the unnecessary editing and the boosh pow and the pop culture references that like 9% of people are gonna be able to get. You know? This is just dumb. It's just, I can't anymore. We're done. You're done. I'm a little bit more depressed now. I'm part of the Nazi party.